Well, I had my coffee, had some rest, and it's time to move on. Also, I previously talked about doing bucket list stunts, but of course I'm at not bucket list. I already did all of them in Horizon, but I will probably redo them for video. But anyway, what I meant was the 1000 Club, and 1000 Club is a free expansion for Forza Horizon 1, not 2. So I definitely will be playing Forza Horizon 1 later at some point. Let's start with the Escalade. It's pretty fast as well. Sorry, not paying attention there. Just doesn't matter right now. Still, you know, the first lap and the first lap is... first of all, you don't have all this run-up. Second of all, it's gonna take me a few laps to get used to the handling of the Cadillac. So far, so good. Definitely one of the best handling cars I've tried today. Well, this would be good and all if I didn't spin right on the finish line. Cars, you can't really throttle the corner like I did there in the previous corner, because it's sort of like you steer and you throttle at an angle, so your car tends to spin out. But this one's pretty good. Alright, let's finish up here and pick up a better ghost.
All right, not bad. But you could pick up more rewards and get to your next wristband faster by driving clean and avoiding collisions.
Only 3 seconds? Interesting. Let's see if I can improve on that time with transit. Overall, I think Forza Horizon's first one is better than the second one, and for I think 3 reasons. I think it's better because there is the rally expansion, which is just fantastic fun. There is the fact that, you know, leaderboards aren't all for you know, the most decked out cars. There are leaderboards for like D-class cars and stuff like that, so you know that creates some kind of variety. And I think the actual the expansion, the free expansion that gives you the thousand club or whatever it's called, I think obviously that adds replayability to the game. You can't always just go on leaderboards. You want to have some more casual fun sometimes. I think that's what it does. I think that they sort of seem to put less effort into the second part. Damn, there is no ghost here. It's bug again. Great sound, isn't it? Poor corner there. There's 3 men. F's, isn't it? Alright, I think I slowed down there in the beginning of it, but the exit was fine. Here I suppose I slowed down a little bit too much. Here pretty good. It was still 2 seconds slower. I felt really good about that though. I don't know. I mean, there were a couple of questionably executed corners in the beginning, but yeah, the brakes here are a bit weird. I mean, not weird, but not like what I feel. Like on the other cars, you need to brake right away, but on this, I feel like you can wait a little bit. I don't know, it's still slower. I expect it to be faster. Usually this one is faster. This was horrible, but I don't know where to start to repair that. Make it look sort of shitty or steel. I couldn't even steer out of the train instead. No, this is gonna be a slow life, but this is life was a mess from the start. Let's finish, let's pick up another ghost, maybe better ghost. I mean, not better, but visible will do fine.
Stay out of trouble and off the walls to claim a clean racing bonus.
Cool. For free loan, maybe even get some kind of changes to the setup. Club 156. Okay. So, what's the stats? I probably should just go this way. 901. Manual clutch seems to be the faster option, but I don't feel like I can. I don't feel comfortable manual clutch in. On without the clutch pedal and stuff. All right, let's actually. Let's go to a garage. I can't. Can't upgrade it here, right? So we need to go to a garage. Just go here, I guess.
there, stranger.
Right, let's check it out. I can only go by this leg. Yeah, better speed is good. Let's get this one for more speed. Didn't feel like it was a rear I think this actually is a good enough change, I feel. I just didn't feel like there was anything particularly wrong with that car handling wise. So, just taking off the rear spoiler should be reasonable. Not sure why Ford Transit is dirt. I don't think it's like a rally car or whatever, just a van. Sure how, you know, it affects balance, for example, because I mean, like, having front spoiler and not having rear spoiler can, you know, affect the way car handles as far as understeer and oversteer is concerned. I'm not sure if, you know, in Forza Horizon it does, or is it just like, oh well, it just affects speed. This car seems to have a real spoiler. He's 6 years older than me. Don't see, like, just Transit doesn't feel faster than Escalade. Escalade feels faster. Like, it feels if you're pure, you know, messing with all those upgrades, probably gonna get more benefit out of messing with upgrades with Escalade than Transit. Well, I guess that's why there are a couple of Raptors that are up top on the board. I think it was a score more better than him. I always get closer after it. It's like, yeah, okay, you turn right, but then you sort of need to get on it flat out, or you lose time. 3 kills. ABS in this game might be crap. Because I think, you know, like when I jump the brakes, it locks up in ABS and all ABS. Which is of course realistic because in real life ABS would also be sort of limited to its ability. Like ABS or no ABS. Jam your brakes, not 20 miles an hour, you're gonna lock it probably. Yeah, I just don't see how I can cut 2 more seconds for my time here. Couple of seconds, I mean not a couple of seconds, maybe a second, yeah. No, I don't like this one. Wanted to cut the corner on the stand, so forced my car into fishtailing. Oh, do I want to continue lap or do I want to finish? I want to finish, I want the next host. Yeah, I only cut a couple of seconds there. Maybe I want a different car as well.
Did you know you can also pick up more rewards through clean driving? Avoid collisions and you can rack up a clean racing bonus.
Checking out where we're getting there. Not that good. I need to cut over 2 seconds. There is no way I can cut over 2 seconds in this car, I don't think. Maybe if I to take off ABS or something. No. Well, let's look at the garage. Let's go into the garage and see. Is there something there we can do?
Hey, how's the...
See, I even had the... Well, let's try this, I don't know. Bigger rims. See, this is particular rim that... This is how precise it is. This is particular rim on the front wheel with which I accomplished the best balance rotational between back and front. I remember on quite a few cars I had a regular stock diff instead of upgraded diff because it saves weight. Well, I don't know, let's go with a good diff. I have no idea if that's gonna help or not. And I think if this try I'm struggle with you know, improving on this try, I'm gonna go with the Escalade, I think, and maybe Raptor try that out as well. So I a bit more sliding here, but why is that? Why is there more sliding? Which upgrade was that? Definitely better rotation ability, but a bit also slidey. Yeah, like this. Just slidey, slidey, slidey. Is it the diff that made it slidey? Not sure. Entirely too much sliding. Wait. It's weird, right? Because you want to go from the outside to the inside because that's how you do it. In real life, that's how physics work. But not here. Here it just washes you out, and if you go tight, you exit tight, which is weird. So. Well, that's not the right way to exit turn, I guess. This definitely feels faster.
Something is like, I just want a bit less slidey, a bit less rotation. Maybe I should like read online some kind of guide what everything does, because I have no idea. I just experiment and I base my guesswork on real life, right? But it's not real life, it's not even a simulator, it's an arcade game. Normally I think the diff would minimize the sliding, but happens out of this. Honestly, sometimes I'm so absent-minded, I'm just like, I remember I did the diff. And I did, what else did I do? The rally suspension. And something to the tires, but I don't remember what I did to the tires. I remember that I left the rims as they were. I think it's the width. I made them wider, right?
Faster by driving clean and avoiding collisions.
There, man. Kevin Randleman died. Shame, man, he was... I mean... I like the guy.
Dude, come on!
With a controller. I'm 16th with a controller. This is best performance with a controller for me. Maybe I'm better with a controller after I played Army of Two on hard. Made me more precise and stuff. Pretty good result. Yeah, I made the front end. Alright, let's try this way. I wish it would have like a quick go to the last arrival match thing. Let's go number 13, you and me. Thank you. should slide through there. Cutting grass is the way to go, but then you cut the grass, you start to lose control because slippery and steering isn't working out. Which is obviously realistic enough. So he does have a real spoiler. You need to sort of like aim to slide through the blue pole. No, not like that. That's just going sideways. Yeah, something like going straight through it. Slide or slide aiming toward it, then go through it. I think I gained some speed through the last corner, some distance in my body. So much that sometimes when you use rewind you lose time when you ghost. Which is fair, you know, if you're abusing rewind like I am. But serves you right. Almost got through there.
You've missed the checkpoint.
Need to like sort of modulate. No, maybe nothing like that. Alright, let's try it. Again. Oh, that was almost good. There, but sort of rubbed off on respawn the friction. So. And then there was that. Oops. Oh my god.
Hold up, mate! You've missed the checkpoint.
Yeah, I don't think I can get it through here without losing even more speed from the Tesla. Judge where exactly you know, exits, but I lose a lot of time here on the world, otherwise usually I don't lose much. Like if you lose some time, so usually little, but not all the time, but like a car length. Wow. It doesn't even break through there. It's insane. And again, literally just rewinding here is rewinding here makes me lose the yeah so much. Breaking. I need to definitely turn off ABS, because that's enough is enough. With ABS it just doesn't work at all.
That was close.
Just a bit. Just a bit more and I would have hit it. And now just shitty turn instead. With my car. I don't think I can beat him, I just don't. Because this is like right here, what he does here. break and like corner less effective than he does. So whatever he does is mental. I'm gonna try to feed.
Yo, bud, how's things?
Okay. Let's go with bigger wits and let's check out the big rims. Maybe that'll bring something to the table. Get EBS off. Alright, that'll good for now. That'll do for now. Also, locking brakes is generally not that big of a problem in this game. Because, especially if you lock the gears, in rotation. Still don't know how he does it, but I think go through that section flat out. Maybe I'll put a few. Sometimes, sometimes to get used to no ABS. The car brakes a bit too well without ABS. But less rotation. I'll get used to it, I see. It's not easy to get used to. No ABS. When you're just used to this. Essentially, what you do with ABS is like, okay, you not necessarily always slam the brakes, but you almost slam the brakes. And, you know, to achieve the same kind of power without ABS, you really need like very gentle taps on. Like, if I press down the tab, the left tab, like 10%, it's the same as you braking with ABS and you're pressing the tab down, I don't know, 90%, so. You have to really get used to it, and it doesn't help when you bloody speed and come in there. You can actually see where I lost traction all the way over here.
Checkpoint.
I think I'm pretty close to just going with the steering wheel instead. I don't think I like the big rims. I think the big rims they're slowing me down. Doesn't feel quite as well with rotation. Sort of like makes my car wash out. Maybe now I need a real spoiler with the bigger wheels. Maybe that's the key. Until now it worked well, way too well. Yeah, it just feels like with some bigger wheels you do need the rear spoiler, maybe that's really just no traction whatsoever with those bigger rims. Maybe he will have
grand.
Grand spoiler. That's why he turns into. Get here. Fast. Oh my god, just so... You know, after... I gotta tell, after you break like that, right? That's when you gain all the traction. Not lose the traction. If you let go of your brakes... And you slow and you go off your brakes, you have traction, all the traction, all the mechanical traction in the world. Not that, oh, you've just been going fast. You let go of the brakes, no traction. How fast you were going previously is irrelevant. It doesn't matter how fast you're going now. Even if the tires overheat, if I'm going this slow, exiting this slow out of the corner, any tires will hold. That was very quick break. And now it's very slow break. Alright. I mean, I can't blame this one on the game. This one is all me because it's the way I set up the braking. Wait. What happened? Why did the lap not count? Alright, let's finish and let's get the spoilers. I think the spoilers are relevant here.
Where you been keeping yourself?
All right, let's get the spoilers, and I think that's what the professionals have as well. More speed. Okay, so that's how they get. But this slows down the car by a lot, by 2 points. Jeez. Alright, let's go with all the stuff, I don't know. Then we'll figure it out. It actually drops it. Alright, let's just go with this one and then we will figure it out. now I'm gonna be behind on him just to kill him. But yeah. I guess that's fair. That one, what is that supposed to mean? Why, when I am taking the correct line, I cannot hit the apex, but if you're on an inside, you can hit the apex. How does it work? Obviously, my level of grumpiness will rise the boundary to the top. traction control. Let's see if that's gonna help at all.
You've missed the checkpoint.
It definitely nails that corner. Nails that corner and the last corner.
The checkpoint. That's actually why I do really, really hate setups anymore. Because, especially in the computer games, the setup. Hold up, mate! You've missed the checkpoint!
Like, there have been known to be bugs in setups, which gives you, like, there's a certain combination of things that gives you an advantage that wasn't intended to be there. But also, in general, like, know what the top guys are using. I can see that their car, that this guy's car, for example, again, it's not, it's only like rank 13. So whatever he's using might be different from whatever the guy who's at the top is using. But it sort of creates a new playing field. I think games should be all about skill and not about just feeding you some kind of imaginary. Imaginary upgrades. PJ Salt. No, I mean, PJ Salt or not, it really is so annoying that I'm gonna sit here and just fiddle with those things when I could just beat him. Well, not. I mean, I'm not implying that I'm, you know, some kind of god of this game or whatever. I am gonna beat him, but I'm gonna beat him after fiddling with setup for a couple of hours, and I could save maybe, I don't know, a couple more hours if I just, you know, knew what setups is other people using. But as I said, this guy has a brilliant setup for going through corners, but it's entirely possible that the guy you can see at the towers in the board is slower through the corners, but for example he's like slightly blisteringly fast on the straight. And yeah, that is also annoying because you can get, you essentially can break way too well and you're gonna be punished for it because you just broke before the corner, way before the corner. Which is again fair, but
let's remove the large rims, I think they are an issue.
I'll get you, Corey John, I'll get you. It does feel better without the figurines, but is it faster? I gotta say, it was so much more like... When you have ABS on, there was one thing that I missed, and it's reliability. ABS pretty much always break the same, but... Threshold breaking, obviously, it's slightly different because, well...
Hold up, mate! You've missed the checkpoint!
I'm new to it and I make mistakes, that's why you give me that.
Oh,
if I hit it, it'll be alright, but no. Way behind. Well, made a mistake as well. Just floored way too hard. It's so hard to guess. If you resume mid-corner, it's so hard to guess what your hand position was on the controller. Like, how hard way you turn it and stuff. Shame. Oh my god. How does he do that? How does he turn so much better there? Magic is this. Corey, how do you do that? That was good first card. Well, that was it. Just messed up on the second one. I definitely can beat Corey, but a second? I don't think so. That being said, if I could learn his secret on how to do the last corner, I don't know how much time I can gain there. Quite a bit, I think, considering how long this straight is. It's not a straight, I should say, flat out section. Flat out section. Long flat out section.
Focus, Tavi.
I took a bit of rest. Should have been more. Should have approached that corner with less of a sharp angle. Here I just lose. Unbelievable amount of time to avoid. Where did this torpedo go? How? Up in this position, I sort of was autopiloting there for a bit, and so I was like, and I'm like, how am I? What's going on? Salt for sure. And again, you know, like I just I rewind all the same things, and all of a sudden I'm not from the outside of the land, I'm totally on the inside. Makes no sense. There is just a certain inconsistency in the engine's car, the amount of traction, the amount of grip it gets.
It's a checkpoint. You've missed a checkpoint. Checkpoint.
There is, I feel, no other real option when you sort of trying to cut the corner here. I mean, you can cut it a bit more than normal by going through the inside, I guess. There. But yeah, you oftentimes will just miss it by a fraction of a distance. Insert your distance here. Can do better. Dear Lord.
continuous and reliable amounts of traction. I just was so afraid I'm gonna miss it that I didn't really try to correct it after the... Well, actually, when I say that this game has an elaborate amount of traction, I'm not very sure that that's true, because it also depends entirely on the... Well, not entirely, but a large portion depends on your controller. My controllers aren't the kind of... Because they don't have the kind of range and the kind of accuracy that, for example, Club Sport will have. This Xbox controller isn't the most precise thing ever. To be honest, so far I only played two games which are entirely without fault, and that is iRacing and Assetto Corsa. Because when you start playing them, and you it just feels right, you know, it feels just like real life physics, you know. You never have that kind of moment where you think like it's not my fault, it's a game. I have different expectations of the game is being consistent, the game is being realistic, something like that. None of that is present in iRacing, none of that is present in Assetto Corsa. And then there is a reason why people, well, those two are generally, those two and R Factor are the best sims ever. I'm so far away from being able to go through that corner at the speed that Corey is going, that I just, like, I can't even think what kind of setup changes
I can possibly do taco. Like, at no point in my setups, and I tried quite a few of them, how I felt like, oh yeah, I can do that at that speed. Slower, and I still cannot make it. Cannot turn in there. Maybe he brakes a little gently. Maybe. But his brake lights don't go up. He's not braking there at all. I think ghost brakes have to go up. I don't know, I need to see. That being said, I also am playing still with the controller, and maybe if I took the wheel out, I would do better. But that's not necessary. What do I want to do? I wanted to drop that. Alright, let's try with this one. Next change, if I need, I'm gonna try to go with non-rally suspension, the rail suspension. There we go, rally suspension installed, but it said that it's faster. That's the little number that said that it's faster. I like that the slipperiness of this. Maybe there may be something there. General personal preference, I prefer the cars that are more slippery. Maybe I can improve on his time here even while being slower, but that would be suck if you get here faster than him, and then the last bits he overtakes you, is straight on speed. there is a handicap here for using auto manual gearbox. I think there probably is, since most level players use manual clutch. When I do my Thrustmaster, the most basic Thrustmaster I have friends, but I do go manual. Not always though. I think when I was racing hypercars, at some point I felt that it was more beneficial to me to just not even rattle the wheel, because there was so much speed and so little grip. I felt like even if I was just keeping my wheel as free as possible, it's more benefit for me than it was more benefit for me than actually whatever benefit gives me. I'm gonna connect to Xbox Live because I don't want my world records that I'm about to set not recorded. Good. Cannot be quarry, so let's just next try. We're gonna attempt to just start taking that corner as good as possible for our setup. Bro, just, you know, was breaking way too well in there. We'll be broke. It's been already like 2 hours of streaming, and I only made improvements in the first hour of it, I think. And the second hour was all suffering with Scotty. There's just something different in setup of Corey cars that allows him to take corners a lot better than I can. And I don't know what it is. And again, he takes his corners so much better than it's not just, you know, one thing, it's some kind of combination of things. I think it's a bit easier in general to devise racing lines when you are racing strictly on tarmac, like if all grass was a thing, it would be a bit more straightforward. Because here you really want to cut that corner, but you're just not sure by how much. Yeah, not like that. So it's a bit, gives you a bit more to think about, and also obviously when you hit grass, it adds new difficulty in guessing grip levels, and not only that, but also the grip levels are generally differ very drastically from the angle you take that patch of grass at. So he doesn't break here at all. Oh, but this is very fun to watch. Oh man. Grunts. And exhales while playing the video game. God,
you've missed the checkpoint.
Good one. That's a good one as well. If this is right, I'll be way ahead of him because this corner will be better than he does. That's not the way to do it. Yep. Because I was scared of him, I actually did it slower. I just lose because I rewind it. That sort of looks reasonable, I guess. Please don't get me to get straight line speed. Finally. Thank you everyone who was with me through that period of pain and suffering.
Stay out of trouble and off the walls to claim a clean racing bonus.
Time to see the glorious benefits, the glorious rewards of my efforts. How far did I end up? Eighth. Pretty good. That's sweet, but I need to eat and I need to refocus and PJ salt less and all that stuff. So I'm gonna cut here, I'm gonna eat. I'm gonna think about life and the meaning of it, and then I'm gonna come back and beat this agent guy, right? No, Eagle 22. I think they're from like the same clan or whatever. Anyway, I'll be back soon. For now, bye bye.